Hi, let's talk about the thoracic aorta. In this video, we'll discuss the course of the thoracic aorta as well as its parietal and visceral branches and their targets. So the thoracic aorta consists of three parts. There's the ascending aorta, the arch of aorta, and then the thoracic part of the descending aorta, which runs between the T3 level to the aortic hiatus, which is approximately at the T12 level. That descending part continues through the retroperitoneal space of the abdominal pelvic cavity as the abdominal part, where it eventually multifurcates at approximately the L4 level into the common iliac arteries and the median sacral artery. Specifically, we'll look at this thoracic part of the descending aorta, which is going to assume a left lateral position within the posterior mediastinum. And to do this, I've included two illustrations and a cadaveric view for our use here. I'd like to start with this transverse section. It's quite simplistic, but my point in including it is so that we can see that the parietal branches of the thoracic aorta generally leave posterolaterally, whereas the visceral branches, while not all in the same plane, are going to assume more of an anterolateral departure from the thoracic part. So there are very many visceral branches and parietal branches. Let's start with the parietal branches. Now, we know that the thoracic part begins at approximately the T3 level. And so, serving the posterior and lateral walls of the thorax are going to be the posterior intercostal arteries. These will anastomose with the anterior intercostal branches of either the internal thoracic artery or its branches to form the intercostal arteries. But here we have posterior intercostal arteries 3 through 11. We also have a pair of subcostal arteries below the 12th rib, as well as superior phrenic arteries, which are going to anastomose with pericardiacophrenic arteries, as well as musculophrenic arteries. These are branches of internal thoracic to serve the superior surface of the diaphragm with blood. Now, the visceral branches are fairly straightforward. We have bronchial arteries. The bronchial arteries are of particular interest to us in this session because they're going to serve the bronchi and the tracheobronchial tree. Everything that's proximal to the respiratory bronchioles can be served by these arteries. They'll also serve the superior portion of the esophagus within the thorax. These bronchial arteries have quite a variable set of origins. The left two bronchial arteries, which I'll just point out to us right there, are going to generally leave at about the fifth level, which is here. So they're a little high here in the illustration. But they're going to be branches directly of the thoracic part of the descending aorta. Whereas the right bronchial artery, which is what I'm indicating here, is generally either a direct branch of the right third posterior intercostal artery or a branch of the superior left bronchial artery. Those are the two most frequent places that that right bronchial artery may originate from. There are also pericardial arteries. These are very tiny branches that are going to serve the posterior aspect of the pericardium with blood. We have mediastinal arteries, which are going to supply various elements of the mediastinum, especially lymph nodes, with blood. And then finally, most distally among all of these visceral branches are the esophageal arteries. The esophagus is supplied by a number of different small branches, but these esophageal arteries tend to originate low within the posterior mediastinum. We can't see them here, but we can see this very close association between the thoracic part of the descending aorta and the esophagus. And this should be maintained within your memory bank when we think of how we might image the aorta. So transesophageal ultrasonography is made possible as a result of this relationship. And we can see that this relationship between the esophagus, which I'm outlining here, and the descending part, or the thoracic part of the descending aorta, which is here, is very close-knit. And so those esophageal branches really have no need to travel very far as they move. So we've discussed the course of the thoracic aorta, as well as the specific course of the thoracic part of the descending aorta, and the branches, both visceral and parietal, of the thoracic part of the descending aorta. This is your summary slide. Thank you for your time.